As an aquatic biologist, Tim Wong is responsible for all kinds of water-loving wildlife at the California Academy of Sciences in San Francisco.
They're a stick insect, and actually one of the largest insects in the world.
But it's another kind of insect that really sets his heart aflutter.
Native butterflies were kind of always a part of my life growing up.
One particular species caught your eye.
Yeah, and it's just such a beautiful, iridescent, blue, tropical-looking butterfly.
The California pipevine swallowtail is native to Northern California. But in the last century, as San Francisco grew, nearly all of its habitat was lost to urban development. Gone was the one plant it needs to complete its life cycle, the pipevine.
This is all native vegetation.
It is, yeah. So it's
on the living roof at the Academy of Sciences, Wong began his one-man mission to grow more pipevine and, in turn, bring back the pipevine swallowtail.
So what we're looking at here is a buffet for the caterpillars, right?
It is, yeah.
At San Francisco's Botanical Gardens, where Wong created a habitat ideal for the swallowtail,
she's looking for the perfect spot to lay her eggs. They're actually really picky.
He's become known as the butterfly whisperer.
You can think like a butterfly?
I can kind of think like a butterfly, and I almost know what they're looking for.
What butterflies of all kinds are looking for is the right habitat. That is becoming increasingly difficult for nearly every species as their natural environments are disappearing.
The single greatest cause of extinction is the loss of habitat.
Bill Toon's organization, EcoLife, is working to protect the forest in Mexico, where the most studied butterfly, the monarch, spends the winter. In the last 20 years, the population of monarchs has dropped by more than 80% as its habitat has disappeared. That's raising concerns because butterflies, like bees, contribute to the food chain, playing a critical role in the plant fertilization process.
Butterflies are important because they're a pollinator, and pollinators account for one out of every three bites of food we take. Without them, we will die.
Toon is part of a campaign spearheaded by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, encouraging communities to replant native species, creating butterfly gardens to help them survive. In San Francisco, retired firefighter Mike Belcher has done just that.
It's kind of like ranching. You raise cattle, you grow alfalfa, so I grow plants for butterflies.
Belcher's butterfly oasis includes all kinds of flowering plants and a huge pipe vine for that elusive San Francisco butterfly.
I planted it here 17 years ago with the hope that someday maybe the pipevine swallowtail would find it and breed here.
And this year they did, for the first time, laying eggs on his pipe vine.
The line I use is, if you plant it, they will come.
Eventually.
You just gotta wait.
Good to have them back in San Francisco.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Belcher figures much of the credit goes to Tim Wong's work, and it's finally paying off. Wong's plants now have a bumper crop of eggs.
And they're laid in clusters because when the caterpillars hatch, they forage as a group and feed like a little caterpillar army.
The return of the pipevine swallowtail is encouraging, but the monarchs face a long and challenging journey back from the brink. Both need a lot of help from their friends. John Blackstone, San Francisco.